Good morning, everyone. We thank God so much for today, His mercies and compassions, they fail not. His mercies are new towards us this morning. Today we are going to be looking at a very important topic that is so integral to our work with our Maker. We are going to look at the topic, keep watch. Keep watch. Remember, we are admonished in 1 Peter chapter 5 that we should be sober and vigilant, for our adversary, the devil, walketh about like a roaring lion, seeking whom to devour. So we are going to look at that very integral topic. And more so not because of the devil, but to have a relationship with our Father, our Maker, our Creator, our Source. That is the topic we are going to be looking at this morning. Keep watch. So I want you to quickly join in, invite your family and friends all to join in. And as we do that, I want us to start speaking in tongues and edify ourselves. You know, when we speak in tongues, we edify ourselves, we charge ourselves up, we connect immediately into the spirit realm. And guess what? The cool part of it also is that the devil does not understand what you are saying when you speak in tongues. You can get that reference from 1 Corinthians chapter 14 and verse 14. So I want us to invite our family and friends, and also just click on the lower left button, share this quiet time right away. Let it be a blessing to many people out there. And we speak in tongues and do that. Then we look into the word and we pray a little bit after the broadcast. Let's do that right away. Mayanderebo setayandaraba kenderebo shetelebedelebede. Imamandaraba darababa setelebe kunderebo shenderebe agarabebe. Ibabandaraba darabo setenderebo shenderebedelebe. Yanderebo setaraba daraba kenderebo shenderebe. Iba bandala bandele mo zikendele mo shindele ve andala bara ikendele mo sitele ve komba yindele mo shindala ma bedele bene ima bandala bandala mo zikendele mo shandele ve andala bikendele ve ima bandala ve dole mo sitele ve konda la mo shindala ma bere bole ima bandala bandele mo sitele ve konda la mo shindala ma bodele ve andala bene. I can da la bossi celebe con da la boschin da la babe. I mamma da la vada la bossi can da la boschin da la babi da la be con da la bassi celebe con da la bene. I mamma can da la bosche celebe con banden da la bossi celebe do da la bi can da la bine. Voyon da la bossi da la be cata la bosche da la babi da la be copa renda la basso celebe. Ima be kendere bo, je vinda la mambe dere ve komba vinda re bo se tare ve don da la bara. Ima kenta la bo shenda la bi kenta re be, zo vendo la mandi li be ko tere monde re. Vionda la masube, kenta re mo shenda la vadi dere ve so tere venda la vire. I kenta re bo shuba denda la mo, si kenta la ma shoma denda la mene. Yonda remo si peketere bo shoma re la re katona la madon. Me yonda la masu tere ve konda la bashonda le ve da ribo ketere veno. Mo yonda la bose tala biken dere bo shenda le ibo kotere vim. Mo yonda la mose da biken dere mo shenda le mo tenda la mi. Konda le ve tore bo si pare keta bo shante le mo da rike kotere ve. In the name of Jesus, dear Lord, we come before you this morning. We give you all the praise. We give you all the honor so much for today, for helping us to see today. We are blessed and honored to be part of the faith of July 2017 that you have created. Dear Lord, we thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercies that are new unto us this morning. We thank you that you are touched by the feeling of our infirmities. Lord, we give you all the praise, give you all the glory for who you are. Dear Father, as we look at this integral word from you this morning, we pray, oh Lord, that you connect us, oh Lord. You grant us the grace to pray. the grace, oh Lord, to yearn for your presence, to be with you in the name of Jesus. The grace to yearn to communicate and commune with you, oh Lord. We pray, Father, for understanding, for wisdom and insight into this secret in the name of Jesus. We thank God so much. Good morning one more time. My name is Pastor Mrs. Engineer Joan Bright. I bring you the quiet time written by my father, Bishop Dagiwon Mills, on behalf of my husband, my pastor, my king, my Lord, the one and only living mandate, who is also my counselor and my producer. Ain't I so blessed? He extends his love to you this morning. Today we are going to be looking at one of the mandate secrets, which is to keep watch. There is nothing any man can do without God being with the person. And the way you get God to be with you is by having a close walk with him, a close relationship with him. How do you develop a relationship with someone? You develop a close relationship by staying in touch with the person, by communicating with the person. A relationship dies as in the moment you start, you break the chain of communication. Once you break the chain of communication, the relationship begins to die. The mandate is always praying, always praying, always in touch with God to know what to do next, what move to make, where to go, what to do, what to say. Always praying. That is what we are all supposed to do. We are all supposed to keep in touch with God. He is the most important person, and God, our relationship with God, our relationship with God is the most important relationship that we are supposed to build. And we build that relationship by keeping watch, by praying, by communing with our God. Today, I want us to read the whole of Acts chapter 16. Acts chapter 16. We are going to look at that. How prayer works in our favor. How God steps into our situation, and when we pray. That is what we are going to look at as we read Acts chapter 16. Paul, the apostle who we all admire, who wrote, who extended the gospel to major parts of the world and most parts of the world, who was used by God extensively, was a man of prayer. And he was able to overcome the circumstances, the obstacles that came his way, because he kept watch, because he was always in touch with God in prayer. He did not only pray when things were good, he prayed when things were good, he prayed when things were bad. We are supposed to pray all the time. 1 Thessalonians 5:17 says, pray without ceasing. Pray without ceasing. We are supposed to pray all the time. All the time. Acts chapter 16, reading from the New Living Translation so that we can go a little faster. Paul went first to Derbe and then to Lystra, where there was a young disciple named Timothy. His mother was a Jewish believer, but his father was a Greek. Timothy was well thought of by the believers in Lystra and Iconium. So Paul wanted to join them. Paul wanted him to join them on their journey. In defense to the Jews of the area, he arranged for Timothy to be circumcised before they left, because that was the period where Paul was being persecuted by the Jews, and they were telling him that he was not a Jew and all of that. So he wanted to make sure that even his ministry team were circumcised. and were Jews before taking him on the journey into those territories. So he arranged for Timothy to be circumcised before they left, for everyone knew that his father was a Greek, but his mother was Jew. But everybody was always thinking that, talking about the fact that his father was Greek. Verse 4. Then they went from town to town, instructing the believers to follow the decisions made by the apostles and elders in Jerusalem. So the churches were strengthened in their faith and grew larger every day. Verse 6. Next, Paul and Silas traveled through the area of Phrygia and Galatia, because the Holy Spirit had prevented them from preaching the word in the province of Asia at that time. So that was a leading of the Holy Spirit. Verse 7, then coming to the borders of Mysia, they headed north for the province of Bithynia. But again, the Spirit of Jesus did not allow them to go there. So instead, they went on through Mysia to the seaport of Troas. Verse 9. That night, Paul had a vision. A man from Macedonia in northern Greece was standing there, pleading with him, "Come over to Macedonia and help us." So we decided to leave for Macedonia at once, having concluded that God was calling us to preach the good news there. We boarded in verse 11 to a boat to Troas and sailed straight across to the island of Samothrace. And the next day, we landed at Neapolis. From there, we reached Philippi, a major city of that district of Macedonia and a Roman colony. And we stayed there several days. On the Sabbath, we went a little way outside the city to a riverbank where we thought people would be meeting for prayer. And we sat down to speak with some women who had gathered there. Verse 14. One of them was Lydia from Thyatira, a merchant of expensive purple cloth who worshipped God. As she listened to us, the Lord opened her heart and she accepted what Paul was saying. Verse 15. She and her household were baptized, and she asked us to come to be her guests. "If you agree that I am a true believer in the Lord," she said, "come and stay at my home." And she urged us until we agreed. Verse 16. One day, as we were going down to the place of prayer, we met a slave girl who had a spirit that enabled her to tell the future. She earned a lot of money for her masters by telling fortunes. She followed Paul and the rest of us, shouting, "These men are servants of the Most High God. They have come to tell you how to be saved." This went on day after day. So this was a lady, a girl, who had a foul spirit, but she was saying the right thing, that these are men of God, servants of the Most High God, who have come to tell us how to be saved. Despite the fact that she was saying the right thing, she was not being led by the Spirit of God. Now, Paul was able to identify this because he was being led by the Spirit of God. He was a man of prayer. Now, this went on in verse 18, day after day, until Paul got so exasperated that he turned and said to the demon within her, "I command you in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her." And instantly it left her. Verse 19, her masters, now comes a whole brand new problem for them. Her master's hopes of wealth were now shattered. So they grabbed Paul and Silas and dragged them before the authorities to the marketplace. The whole city is in an uproar because of these Jews. They shouted to the city officials, "They are teaching customs that are illegal for us Romans to practice." Imagine. Now, because their source of livelihood was taken away, because the devil in the girl was taken out, they now started lying against Paul and Silas. Meanwhile, when the girl was prophesying, and they were getting money. And she was saying even the right things, which was that they were servants of the Most High God who have come to tell us how to be saved. Because they were getting their money, they had no problems with it. But as soon as their money, the source of income was shattered, they now came up, contorted, and created a story just to get rid of them. Verse 22, a mob quickly formed against Paul and Silas, and the city officials ordered them stripped and beaten with wooden rods. 23, they were severely beaten and then they were thrown into prison. The jailer was ordered to make sure they didn't escape. So the jailer put them in the inner dungeon and clamped their feet in the stocks. Around midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God. So in such a precarious situation, Paul and Silas were singing hymns to God, which is also a form of prayer. So in a situation like that, we are not supposed to be crying and to be downhearted, but we are supposed to lift up our voice and call on the name of our God. If you find yourself in a difficult situation, in a situation where someone is accusing you wrongly, call on the name of the Lord. God will come for you. He will defend you in the name of Jesus. So around midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God. They were not sitting down wondering, sitting down getting worried, sitting down crying. They were calling, praying, and singing hymns to God, who is their defense, who is their source. And the other prisoners were listening to them as they were doing this. Verse 26, suddenly there was a massive earthquake. Imagine how God came through for them. There was a massive earthquake, and the prison was shaking to its foundations. All the doors immediately flew open, and the chains of every prisoner fell off. It was not even just the chains of Paul and Silas that fell off, but the chains of every prisoner fell off. That is a show of my Father, the mighty God that we serve. He came forth mightily for them. That is how he will come mightily for you if you keep watch and you pray for him. Sometimes the mandate, we find ourselves in difficult countries, difficult cities, and we just lift up the name of the Lord as he leads us in prayer. Before we realize it, the land opens and things just start working amazingly. That even blows our imagination. When God does it, he said that, I will do it above all that you can ever imagine or think. And that is exactly our God. And that is how he does his things. So keep praying, keep believing until that breakthrough comes forth. The jailer in verse 27 woke up to see the prison doors wide open. He assumed the prisoners had escaped, so he drew his sword to kill himself. But Paul shouted in verse 28 to him, stop, don't kill yourself, we are all here. The jailer called for light and ran to the dungeon and fell down trembling before Paul and Silas. Then he brought them out and asked, says, what must I do to be saved? So that was a double impact blessing. Apart from Paul and Silas being delivered, that showed forth that they were serving a mighty God. That came to silence the voice of the accusers, that they were not preaching customs and doctrines contrary to the Roman Empire, but they came to speak the word of God. Verse 31, they replied, believe in the Lord Jesus and you'll be saved, along with everyone in your household. And they shared the word of the Lord with him and with all who lived in his household. Verse 33, even at that hour of the night, the jailer cared for them. So now he turned to care for them and wash their wounds. And he and everyone in his household were immediately baptized. the one who jailed them, the one who was put in charge to make sure that they did not run away from the prison. Now God touched his heart. Now he was the one who was now taking care of them. Your enemies will turn around to be a blessing to you in the name of Jesus. He brought them into his house in verse 34 and set a meal before them. Remember in Psalm 23, oh my, when my husband preaches this message, I just find it amazing that it is the same Psalm 23. Great revelation. Then when he illustrates it, when the Bible says in Psalm 23 that I will prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies. Remember that scripture? My. That was just what was happening to Paul and Silas right here. He brought them into his house and set a meal before them. And he and his entire house will rejoice because they all believed in God. The next morning, the city officials sent the police to tell the jailer, let those men go. Now the city officials, God touched their hearts. God touched their hearts because Paul and Silas prayed and sang hymns to God when they were in prison. They prayed and called on the name of the Lord. They kept watch. They stayed up praying. They stayed up praying, not sleeping. Their worries are away, but they stayed up praying, calling on the name of the Lord, they are God. So apart from all their chains being broken, then number two, the chains of all the prisoners fell off. No, first of all, the prison doors were opened. Then their chains fell off, the chains of all the prisoners fell off. Then the jailer being saved with his entire household. The jailer washed their wounds and dressed up their wounds. Then the jailer prepared a table before them, nice sumptuous meals. As if all of that blessing was just not enough, God touched the hearts of the officials and told and sent police to tell the jailer to let those men go. Now come see the bluffing of Paul in verse 30. Let's continue. So the jailer told Paul, the city officials have said you and Silas are free to leave. Go in peace. Verse 37. But Paul replied, they have publicly beaten us without a trial and put us in prison. And we are Roman citizens. So now he had to pull out from his portfolio the fact that he was a Roman citizen. So now they want us to leave secretly? Certainly not. Tell them, come themselves to release us. Verse 38, when the police reported this, the city officials were alarmed to learn that Paul and Silas were Roman citizens. So they came to the jail and apologized to them. That is what God can do. He can cause those who accuse you to come with bended knees to apologize to you when you call on his name. When you call on his name, oh God will come through for you just as he came through for Paul and Silas. Then they brought them out and begged them. They had to beg them to leave the city. Verse 40. When Paul and Silas left the prison, they returned to the home of Lydia. There they met with the believers and encouraged them once more. Then they left town. Wow. What is my God? So let's keep watch. Let's pray. Let's stay in touch with God. He will come through for us. Jesus tells us in Matthew 26, verse 41a, he says that watch and pray that ye enter not into temptation. Watch and pray. Not that watch and pray doesn't mean that when you are praying, your eyes should be necessarily open. Physically, your optical eyes should be open necessarily, but we are supposed to be watchful, meaning vigilant, alert, and pray so that we do not enter into temptation. My father, Bishop Daniel Mills, says that long prayer must not be an explicit, is not an explicit instruction in the Bible, but it is implicit throughout the word. There are four important times to pray. We are supposed to pray in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, and the fourth one is all the time. Jesus prayed in the morning, and so do I, my father says. In Mark 1:35, you see Jesus woke up. He says that a great while before day, he woke up to pray. Prayer in the morning is very good because you meet God before you meet the devil. When you pray in the morning, you meet God before you meet the devil. He empowers you, strengthens you to come against anything that may try to throw you off course. God is able to deliver you. You meet God before you meet the circumstances of life when you pray in the morning. God anoints you to overcome every mountain that you will encounter in your life. When you pray in the afternoon, it signifies that in the heat of the day and in the thick of the battle, yes, we are in a constant battle all the time. In the thick of the battle, in the heat of the day, you recognize God as the important force in your life. Mark 6:46 is our reference right there. For the sake of time, I can't read all the scriptures. Kindly do read them. You can take a little time off your lunch break and pray. It will do you a lot of good. It is also important to pray in the evenings. When the Bible says watch and pray, it does not mean keep your eyes open when you pray. What it actually means is stay awake and pray. There is something about praying in the night that is so, so different from praying during the day. Luke 6:12. I have heard stories that witches are very active around 2 a.m. in the night. Perhaps when you pray in the night, you are tackling the forces of darkness in a different way. The fourth important time to pray is all the time. All the time. Prayer is intended to be a never-ending stream of communication with our Heavenly Father. He has given us the gift of speaking in tongues to help us to pray. God is happy when His children are constantly in touch with Him. I want you to quickly grab these three books. They will help you immensely to understand this very vital topic, how to pray. You can get How to Pray and The Art of Hearing from the Macarius. The Macarius is 40 collection of my daddy's books, Bishop Dakiwa Mills books, that will so transform your life, and you will be a wonder to many, You will be, you begin to do amazing things when you read these books. They open up your mind, your spirit, to the will of God for your life. They will lead you and help you to have a close walk with God. And I want you to grab this one from the Mantano Essential Charismatic Doctrines. You can use this to teach people, your leaders, your loved ones, your colleagues at work, anyone at all, on how to keep watch, how to stay in touch with our Creator, with our Father, with our Source. These books will be a blessing to you. These books have transformed many lives and are making waves and transcending generations upon generations. Ministries are being transformed as a result of these amazing books. Please call the numbers for me on your screen right away and get these amazing books. They will be a blessing to you. A blessing to you. Visit www.nakiwamills.org. Click on the worldwide offices, click on your country, and you will see the numbers to call right away. I want you to also kindly like our page before you exit, so that you can get all the notifications when the mandate comes your way with these amazing, amazing life-transforming revelations that he gets from our Father's books. They will help you to fulfill your mandate as well. Also, subscribe to our YouTube channel. It's The Mandate TV, spelled Demand, the figure 8 TV, and it will be a blessing to you. God is making waves, and changing lives with these books. Amazing testimonies. We also want to hear from you. Share your testimonies with us. Kindly inbox us right here on the page, and we will be so glad to hear from you. This morning, I want us to pray very quickly. I see so many of you have joined in. Wow, God bless you so much for joining in. Why, very importantly, I see Bishop Abbas really join in all the way from Warri in Port Harcourt in the River State. God bless you so much, Bishop. God bless you for your support, for always supporting the mandate. We really appreciate you, and may the Lord meet you at the point of your need in the name of Jesus. I see, wow, Reverend Vincent Wanga all the way from Kenya. God join in. God bless you so much for joining in today. God bless you. I see Sarah also join in all the way. God bless you so much, Sarah, all the way from Ghana. I see Lady Pastor Shelley and team join in all the way from Ghana. Wow, God bless you, Lady Pastor Shelley. I appreciate you so much. Thank you so much for joining in. I see Rapela Dominique Mahlaheli joining all the way from South Africa. God bless you so much for joining in. We give God praise for your life. Florence Davidson, join in. God bless you, and the mandate himself, join in. Thank you so much, my King, for joining in and for helping me to be a better person. I'm so grateful to God for your life and the opportunity to help you fulfill your mandate. We have Michael Aram join in as well. God bless you, Michael Aram. May the Lord come through for you and deliver you in a miraculous way. In Jesus' name. Amen. So many people join in this morning. God bless you all so much. And may the Lord meet you at the point of your need and deliver you and cause your accusers to turn around, to kneel down and beg you and prepare a table before you, just as we read in the scriptures. I want us, as we end this broadcast, just as we have learned, just to pray a bit. Just to pray a bit. And we will end the broadcast in the next 2 minutes. I want you to always remember that you are a daughter and a son of the Most High God, who created the whole world and everyone in it. Therefore, you are a victor and not a victim of your circumstances. All you need to do is to call on him. And we are going to call on him right now, and I want us to just speak in tongues for the next 2 minutes, and you will have a beautiful day. Mayanderebo sintalama kendarabo shatalama yandarabela. Ikenderemo sintalama shuterebe kondaraba bise talama donderebe. Imama kendarabo shetalama da. Dear Lord, this morning we call on you. I pray, Lord, and I join my heart and my spirit, O Lord, with all those watching me and who will watch this broadcast even after it has ended, Lord. Everyone that has found him or herself, O Lord, in a precarious situation, Lord, I pray, Father, that you will come forth mightily and deliver every one of them in the name of Jesus. Deliver them to the glory of your name, O Lord. Deliver and come forth, O Lord. Come through for them. Just as you came through for Paul and Silas and you delivered them, please come through for them as well in the name of Jesus. Yandaramo seeking derebo shatalama dida derebo kendaraba de dareben. Mayandarama suterebe kendaraba shotalava de darebe kantarame. Veyondarabo se talaba ketarabo shitalava den doreba derebeda. Ikendaramo senda rebe kotaraba shutareben do darabede. Iketarama sonda
ve barico tara moshan tara mendon yandara mosi tere be kontere boshan tere vedere bebe ikendere mosan dere boshan dere be katare vendora bara yandara mosse tara ba kendore moshen tere be dore bade ikatara ba judi li bokondare mosse tara ba dore vede. Dear Lord, we give you all the praise, we give you all the glory for this great deliverance. We thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Have a beautiful day and God bless you. Keep praying, keep watching, keep watch and pray in the name of Jesus. Have a beautiful day. See you tomorrow. Bye.